Hi, I'm Julia and I'm a physicist at CERN. In this tutorial, I will show you how to explore some of the basic principles of one dark matter detection method at home in your kitchen. The best part, you will be able to eat this physics experiment afterwards, maybe even as a Halloween treat. But be prepared, it might get sticky, it will certainly get messy, so make sure to have an adult with you to help you clean up afterwards. So, what do we need? First of all, a laser pointer. Make sure to have one that is safe to use at home and never direct it into someone's eyes. Always use it only under adult supervision. Depending on your color of the laser pointer, so mine is red, you will need food coloring. So in my case, I use red food coloring. In addition, we will need gelatin. I use 10 grams, so that's 6 sheets of gelatin. Then we need tonic water, 1/2 liter, and some sugar. So I have 50 grams of sugar here. In addition, we will need a pot and a heater, something to stir your mixture with, like a fork, then some boxes, ideally of different shapes, something you can put in the fridge afterwards. So I have these and the one in glass here. Then we will need a knife because we will also cut some shapes out of the jelly. Then we need hot water, that's what we have here. And some surface you can clean easily, something like a cutting board. Then a sheet of white paper, and if you have a black light or a UV lamp. Okay, first you need to check the instructions on your gelatin to find out how much liquid it can turn into jelly. But then use at least double the amount. So I use 10 grams, 6 sheets for 1/2 liter of liquid. Now we will pour the liquid into our pot. Was a bit hot. And we will add the jelly. Good. In addition, we need a bit of food coloring. So I will pour in some drops of red food coloring. And I will also add the sugar. Now you will need to stir it until the gelatin is dissolved in the liquid. That will take a few minutes. So I will just get started here. Once your gelatin is dissolved, you can pour it into your different containers. And a bit into this one. And I will also use the glass, just to have a round shape. So now this needs to go into the fridge and it needs to be there for a few hours. So ideally you put it there overnight. Now, while we're waiting, let's briefly talk about dark matter. Most of the matter in our universe is very different from matter we know from our daily life. We call it dark matter because we cannot see it directly. That means, among other things, that dark matter does not emit light. If we cannot see it, how do we know it exists? Well, we can observe the gravity-based effects of dark matter in our universe. One of these gravity-based effects is the so-called gravitational lensing effect. According to Einstein's theory of general relativity, massive objects curve space-time. That applies to ordinary matter in the same way as dark matter. If light passes through an area of weird curved space-time, the light does not seem to travel in straight lines anymore. Instead, it looks like the light is bent around the massive objects that causes the space-time curvature. And this is one way to indirectly observe dark matter. We use telescopes to look for bright galaxies far away in the universe, and then we look for clues that there might be something in between this distant galaxy and our telescopes that curves space-time and thus changes the way the light travels to us. So what does all of this have to do with the jelly we just made? We know a similar effect from optics. Here, light can change its direction when it passes from one transparent medium to another, for example, from jelly to air. And we can use this and make special shapes of transparent material with specific effects on light. That's what we call an optical lens. So let's get ready by preparing a nice clean workspace. I will fill some hot water into this pot here. This will help us to release the jelly out of the container. So just put it in for a few seconds, like this. Now comes the moment of truth. Voila, there is our jelly. So I will cut a triangular shape because that's the closest we can get to dark matter with this. But of course you can cut any shape you want. You can also use a circular shape if you want to play with your jelly lens. Voila. And we will move this bit out of the way. So now it's time to get your laser pointer and your white sheet of paper. And we will also dim the lights a bit to help you see the laser beam going through the jelly. Now focus on the spot of the laser beam on our white sheet of paper. The laser beam represents light from a distant galaxy in this model. So if nothing is in between, you just see that the light goes straight. Now as soon as the laser passes through a weird area of space, in our case the jelly, you will see that the light beam is bent. So now that we finished talking about dark matter, let's come back to the very important question. Can you actually eat this physics experiment? And what about the UV light? We will switch on the UV light to show you. And yes, you can really eat it. Mmm, delicious physics.